quite a lot. So it's a map that they like playing. On the other hand, Immunity's favorite map seems to be Inferno. Again, big thank you to whoever sent these nice little pieces of information to face it, or to specifically to Dan last week.
Okay, so passive start here from Avant-Garde. You can see they're not going to engage in mid just yet, but I wouldn't expect a crazy mid push here from the CTs on the pistol round. So nice flash coming in there for the team, and that's a good start here. It's promising things from Avant-Garde. Nice smoke in the mid area as well. Oh, Ricky gets shot in the back by a teammate there. Down 62 HP, but there is one player, one CT here on the B-bomb site to try and defend it. It's Sniper, he goes down. 3v3 now as the T's plant the bomb. Nice positioning there from Sheep. Gonna get a frag.
It's a really nice idea there by Avant to play the B-split. Sheep, though, he'll get yet another frag. And the bomb planted. Time is ticking for Ricky. He has to go for it. There's pretty low health. He's going to get the first frag. Ship is relatively low. He's on top and he won't be ready for that. As he will clutch the round sheep in a 1v1 and they'll pick up the first round, the pistol round. But we don't see a lot of that. B-split, three guys brushing short, connector smoked off on the pistol round.
Yeah, it was pretty good. Then it was well executed there with the flashbang from the teammate. He was further back, so it's a pop flash, etc. Very well done. So the two players who got kills there, well, three players got kills, but we're going to see two scouts on the CC side. So we've got Yam and Sniper.
This is great position for the scout because you get the jumping shot and it's so accurate on the nerf it, please. It's so accurate and...
Don't get me started on that.
Yeah, I mean, we'll just talk for the whole game about the scout. But yeah, two scout buys is not a bad idea whatsoever. He's actually pushing here, Sniper. And he does catch one of the terrorists.
That's a very aggressive position indeed. Again, from... You saw when he was jumping, he had a sliver of a gap to try and aim with, and I'm gonna double peek, but PTG is gonna go down. Now we've seen some crazy scout rounds from the Oceanic region before, and are they all gonna try and push?
Avant are making a mistake pushing it because number one they've got a guy hidden on the corner, the CTs, and Sniper's already done quite a lot of damage, and he's got a scout.
You can see James is facing the wall in case flashbangs come in, so Sniper's gonna bait for his teammates. James,
he landed another shot.
See how patient he can be. He shouldn't engage the first person. He's not going to wait.
He's gonna go. Oh, he only gets one.
He should have waited. That was really unfortunate. He could have got two, three, four frags there if he had just not pulled the trigger straight away. But obviously, with such mayhem going on, who knows when somebody would flick around to check the corner. It is a common corner to check. But look, Avant-Garde only have two players remaining. They've got a scout and an AK versus a scout and two USPs. Ricky, though, is in a strong position to finish things off here, as he does have the flank. Look at him just creeping behind. Aww. Won't need it as Yam
those scouts
will put in the rest of the work.
Those scouts picked up, I think, almost all the kills, except for the 157 frag that that James made. So very good buy for Immunity, and they actually pick up the second round.
I can only imagine that they tried to push the scout because they probably expected the B site hold to be a lot weaker. Probably expected maybe, you know, there's a scout there and they're going to have more players towards the A site, which is probably why they had that reasoning, but they had to check that corner. You always have to check that corner where James was staying. And despite Immunity winning the round, I think James could have got a lot more damage in there if he was just a little bit more patient. But hey, it worked out in their favor, so never mind.
Look at this by Yam pushing through connector there. Getting close to the ecoing terrorists may not be the best idea, but he did flash himself through. And the terrorists tried to go for that mid control, but get completely shut down by the AK of Rick or Ricker.
Yeah, Ricker playing the piano there with the AK, just tapping all the players down.
Is that supposed to be like a saying Rick, but in an Australian accent? Ricker.
I kind of want to say it in an EastEnders accent. But
yeah, it's an EastEnders accent. Ricky.
Ricky.
I think it's more like that.
Bianca. Ricky.
All right, Ricky.
Anyway, enough of that. Look at this aggressive positioning here from Imagine. Nice positioning, though, by, is that Heinous? I think it's Heinous, but with Oss at the end of it, which I respect. Okay, so good anti-eco here so far. James has 23 HP, but only Sheep remains. So I don't think James will be going down in this particular round. But again, that was good positioning by the T player in T-App. Something we've seen from Virtus Pro recently is Taz playing the Palace area. And he plays a little bit more forward than that, but still a passive position. Almost gets two. Yam goes down, but James gets the trade.
Yum, yum.
And James survives with 4 HP, so that could have been a lot more expensive for the CT side, but something Taz does is he kind of hangs around in like this kind of area.
Yeah.
So he has a small gap. If there are multiple CTs pushing, then he can easily just move to the side and retreat if he needs to. But he'll kind of loiter around here, then go around this way, and just wait for CTs to push, and then go for the assaults onto the site later on. Once his team have control of Connector.
Indeed. Look at this. Fall by now by Avant. They've got the AWP on Sheep. And this is a great position here, by Imagine, to push underpass. To go behind the terrace, and he should be able to pick up an easy frag here as he takes down Chris. And that's 5-on-4 already. Terrace getting ready for the A-shot push. I mean, if you have a guy holding the flank, he has to be aware that he can get pushed from underpass. And now it's going to be they're going to be pushing in towards the site. Entry frag for PT. Bomb will be planted in the smoke. Double Kobe nade, but they won't find any victims. Ricky firing through the smoke, almost actually landing the shot. Now it's a 3v4 retake here for immunity. They're actually pushing through the site, but the smoke's protecting the terrace. And just as I say that, DVR goes down almost immediately. Sheep with a frag. They're at T-ramp. They know exactly where the positions are. An exchange of frags, and all of a sudden, they're two men up. All the terrorists down, and they will get the bomb defuse. Closer round there for Avant, but not good enough.
I think it might have been Ricky who actually got the Dragon Lord drop in a mission, who I was talking about earlier.
Ricky.
Yeah. I haven't got a Dragon Lord. Do you know how much money I've spent trying to get one? Doesn't even make any sense. Like, it's not even really worth trying to do that. Let's not even go into the two Dragon Lord attempts we had on stream for the viewers. Not even for us, for the viewers, where we got an X-ray and an all chameleon, which is the best thing ever. I think in future, we should pick really... the extra skins should be skins where you get, like, really awful drops. So either you get a Dragon Lord or you get, like, nothing. Like, absolutely nothing. But anyway, it is 4-1 in favor of immunity. And we're going to see a battle for Connector here, but the smoke is in favor of the CTs, at least for the moment. But look, there's already a player in the ladder room.
Ricky. He might be able to catch him off if he's not careful. Imagine a great position to hold Connector.
This is a baity angle indeed.
Oh, he sees DVR and he's going to move, and he'll pick up the first frag. Almost, I think he was going to go for the second as well. There was a guy short, Ricky. He'll take down Haz, who was waiting patiently for the moment to push towards window. And Imagine is still here at Connector, keeping control. And right now, Avant are just running out of options.
They're very spread out as well, which is going to make it a lot harder for them to win the round. James in the sneaky spot here. Again, this is a little trick you can do on these boxes where you can just walk up them and then jump up to the top. It's very doesn't look that obvious to you, but it's a very strong position, as you can see there. It's very hard to even see a player standing there. So now, Avant again spreading out. We're not going to see any trade frags from them. Just going one by one, and they're going to die here. That's going to be the round in favor of Unity with nobody dead. So again, they had three players left. We had one person in B, and then one person in Connector, maybe another person in mid. But they once they had limited numbers, they weren't really playing together. And I don't know. I mean, if the player towards B gets the frag, then maybe her teammates can come up short. But yeah. they weren't working to a joint advantage, aim, trying to run distraction or anything.
I guess they're just trying to see if one of them could get a pick before.
Yeah, but it was too disjointed for my liking.
It's the Tech9 train here, and they're going to pushing towards the B site. It can be actually pretty brutal if they're able to flood into the site if they're not shot down at B halls. But two Molotovs are going to slow them down for a few more seconds. Sniper ready with that smoke as well, and he does see them coming. He throws down the smoke. It's a bit too late. It's actually behind them. Great flash though to slow them down. And James is going to start off with the first frag. Chris leading the way here with a Tech9. He'll get an entry on James. And Sniper is on really, really low health. Oh, another frag. It's a double. I don't think Sheep expected Sniper just jump in front of him like that and give away his life. And now it's a 4-on-2 with Ricky and Yam going for the retake. One AWP on Ricky. Yam pushing in from the shop here. DVR with yet another frag. And Yam will be shot down. That's how good the Tech9 can be in those eco rounds. And no armor as well on them.
People say that the... Well, one person says that... Because I said that the Tech9 has too many bullets in the clip. It's got 32 bullets in the clip.
Yeah.
And while that's not the main problem, the main problem is the running accuracy. It's still an issue because there's no dynamic with you pretty much never have to reload the gun in a round, and it shouldn't be like that, I don't think.
Yeah, it's what makes it even sometimes more dangerous than the CZ is because you don't have to reload. So like you can just keep putting pressure on players and just charge them with the Tech9.
I've seen someone get two kills with one clip and have six bullets left. Like the 5.7 has got, I think, 20 bullets in the clip, but 32 I just think is excessive. Anyway, we have two AWPs here for the CT side. Let's have a look at where they are. Yam is playing on the A site. It's got someone in Palace who I think has an AWP. So no, it's Avant who has the AWP. And yeah, it is Avant in Palace. So he needs to be careful with this angle. But he will find the first frag onto Heinous. Ricky is playing an aggressive position in B.
Yeah,
again, you can. There is a more passive angle, which is a lot tighter. But obviously, if people know their angles, they can pass that angle pretty quickly without you getting the frag. So he's gone for a more guaranteed angle. So looks like it's going to be an A push here.
And
there is one player in connected area. So let's see how he contributes later on.
Well, he can push in and do a lot of damage here because none of the CTs are looking at Connector at the current moment. And Chris is going to push through. James has no idea. He's looking at Palace and he will get the first frag and the second. Beautifully done there by Chris. And that opens up the A site completely for the terrorists as they will get the bomb plant and the two-man advantage. It's 4-on-2. Ricky and Sniper have a pretty tough job. One person coming in from shot and Chris is there to stop him. That nade, however, will do a bit of damage on Chris. And Avant seems like they might pick up their third round here. As the rest of the CTs are going for the save and
tap. Someone's
PTG
knocking on the
goes
door.
Down.
Yeah, well, this is that's a really good example of how you play Connector. Something which I think is commonly lacking from North American Counter Strike at the moment, but it's nice to see it being abused properly by the Oceanic team. Absolutely, use it, abuse it. So Ricky
he's gonna save that off.
Yeah, he's gonna save the AWP for now. So, Immunity off to a good start, but Avant-Garde starting to catch up now, starting to make things difficult here for Immunity on the financial side of things. Ricky gonna spend some money, drop some pistols, and again, that's exactly what should have happened on that game of cash where one player had 5,300. Should have dropped pistols for his teammates to balance the money. This is exactly what we've seen from Immunity here, which is a very good play indeed. Look at this from the T's. They're going to go straight up into the A bomb site. No messing around. They're expecting the eco here from the CTs. They're going to have safety in numbers as they clear out this site with nades.
Great. Well done job there by PTG. Gets a frag on Sniper as well. And another on James. Nasri, there is one person here though at the ladder. Imagine P250 can be dangerous if they're not careful about that. And the AWP is still in the hands of Ricky.
But look how Ricky's trying to throw the bait there. He's threw a Molotov almost into Imagine's spot to try and suggest that nobody's there. But the T's are going to be wiser than that. So it's the AWP versus four. Let's see if we can save it this time.
We can get an ace on PTG here if he takes out Ricky. Starts it off with a frag on Haz.
He's got to be careful because he could easily be overwhelmed here. So I think he may have to go for the save now.
He's smart because they've smoked it off, so they're probably going to go for the flank. It's not a very good smoke, though, because it allows Ricky to still... he can get an angle in towards the A site, but... he's not going to be able to save that off. It'll be very, very difficult. He charges through, stops PTG from picking up that ace, and he makes it a 1v2, but it's another round for Avant. Four rounds already on the T side. That's not bad here for Avant, and especially after they lost the second round, I was thinking, they have to be careful because it seems like Immunity look really strong on the CT side, but that shot is insane, Rick.
Now you got to say, man, that shot is insane, Rick.
Man, that shot is insane, Rick.
I think I did it better than you did.
I tried. I've never tried an accent. But the Australian accent, but for the first time, it's all right.
The thing people say in the UK, right, is shrimp on the barbie, but I don't even think they put shrimps on the barbie. People keep saying Strayer in chat, but I don't know what that means. I don't know if that's rude either. I hope it's not rude. Oh, it means Australia. Okay, cool.
James.
I was scared. I was scared Australia. It meant something like, I don't know, something horrible. Strayer.
Australia.
I don't know how they say it to make it sound like Australia.
I don't want to.
There we go.
I wish I could do a good Australian accent.
I wish you could too.
Well, Vance started off nice and slow. They've got the bomb at T spawn. They've got two players over at mid. And it seems like they're moving towards the B site now. That mid push. And I think that perhaps waiting. They're probably waiting for the AWP to move out of position or something, but they've thrown no smoke. Very late connector smoke there. Has tried to get the frag on Ricky. But Ricky's now completely smoked off at connector and window. Sniper's here in the ladder room to stop them from pushing in shot. But they should be aware that this could happen. And he will pick up an easy frag on DVR. But now that they know their position, Chris... oh, look at Chris. This is a great spot for Chris. And he goes through, but Ricky, still alive with 19 health. He'll make the frag. Sniper here, boosted on top of this box of concrete.
How did he not get that frag? The problem is, like, they got a connector frag, but the rest of the team are not in a position to abuse it. Sheep, though, getting a nice frag onto Sniper, but they're still at disadvantage. PT, is he going to see the player in the fireboxes?
He checks Tetris. There's nobody there, and he gets shot down by Yam, who peeks at the right moment. Sheep knows exactly where he is. It's a difficult shot to make. Molotov down. He's going to back away and meet CTs right in front of him. They throw a Molotov with the Glock. He gets the frag. No! James is there. James puts an end to him. 6-4.
Okay, so that was a crucial round for the CTs there. Look at their economy, and you, I'm sure, will agree.
No, so I disagree, James.
We're going to see the buy coming out for both teams. And let's see how much money both teams have afterwards. Again, we are two-thirds of the way into the first half. And post-purchase, both these teams looking pretty ropey at the moment. So whoever loses this round will be in dire straits.
I like the little bit of mathematics you just did there.
Thank you very much.
Impressed.
1 + 1, Availer, is 2.
I won't disagree. Or it can be a window if you do it like a drawing. Did you ever have that joke with people?
No, actually. How do you draw two ones and make it a window?
One plus in the middle, then equals one on the top and one on the bottom. Looks like a window. Four squared window.
No, you're going to have to draw this for me. I don't understand.
I'll write it on your empty notes, mate.
Okay, so you can see Avantgarde playing a passive position there, top mid, just in case there was a push from the CT, something we've seen a lot from Na'Vi, for example, recently. Guardian likes to charge up.
Look
with
at PTG.
AWP.
I was looking at that. I thought PTG was all the way up at shot, but no, he's just leading the way here at B Halls. And this is a very aggressive position here by James. He's going to be punished for that. The 1-for-1 trade going to the benefit of the terrorists. They're pushing through. They know one person's coming in from shot. PTG with another entry frag, and he's been playing quite well when it comes to the entry side of things. Great Molotov here on market. Ricky tries to slow the bomb plant down. And he won't be able to. The bomb will be planted. It's 3-on-3. Immunity now coming in with a retake. Ricky with the Matrix nade there, but oh, look at this positioning here by Imagine. I mean, Sheep probably thought he was smart coming in from there to flank any CTs who are deciding to flank, but it didn't work out for him. They know one person's coming.
Oh,
and Ricky! I don't know how he missed that shot. PTG is still alive, and with 3 frags, he might get a 4K. It's a 1v1, and this would be absolutely huge for him if he picks up this round. Single-handedly, he sees the CT coming in through. He knows he's coming from there, and he hears him. They're running around, but there's not enough time. Imagine
he's going for the knife!
Oh, is it the chance? No, he's just going to make the frag anyway. But great, great play by PTG. Those excellent entry frags. Really smart play, playing with the time there after getting the bomb plant as well. But 6-5 as Avant make it yet another round. And that wasn't bad at all.
He resigned himself to death there and thought he'd go for the kind of the bonus money. Whips out the
he's going
to
die anyway.
The tiger tooth.
Is that an expensive knife?
It is a very expensive knife. I'm not sure if I like it or not, though.
Anyway. I think a lot of the new knives look a bit tacky, to be honest.
The marble fade M9 looks like an Ebola knife. I don't know. It looks like someone's put it in a petri dish with like 12 viruses and just left it there for 2 months. I really don't like it at all. Okay, so it is the anti-eco here, but Immunity getting the first frag with a P2000, no less.
That's quite interesting. They were going for that aggressive push towards ramp. They had two guys there, but then they just backed away after. Good smoke.
PTG's got to be careful there because he
doesn't get
has
overwhelmed.
No one helping him versus Sniper. 3 CTs.
He went for that cheeky little flank, but didn't work out for him.
Speaking of cheeky little flanks, look at James's position. He is going to get the audio info that there is a rotation from T-Spawn towards B. And if one of these
look
guys...
Look at them. They're so far ahead in B-Apps. They knew exactly
they
what they were doing.
Don't check this corner.
Let them go through. Play it poker. Oh, no! Sheep was checking the corner.
See, he played it well by letting the first person pass, but a second person checked. Isn't... Oh, that's going to be so annoying. And now they're walking back towards the A-bomb site.
Yeah,
and now
smart.
Immunity won't have the audio information. Imagine, though, is in a strong position to find out what's going on. And you can see the rotation from the other two CTs already. Yam, though, is in a difficult position now. Oh, he gets cut down. So does Ricky. Only man standing is Imagine. Can he get any more kills? That is the question. They have no idea where he is at the moment.
It'll be difficult, but he might get one.
They're going to be looking everywhere but there, because that's just where they came from. And there it is. 6-6.
That was a violent death. Very violent death.
So, even now the money is still crap for Immunity. If they go for the buy here, that Availer, it's going to be the jumbo sale buy. We're talking...
Jumbo sale?
We're talking Fisher-Price guns. We're talking... I don't even know what. We're talking
second-hand
remote control cars that only go forward and left.
Sunday market buys.
Yeah, Sunday market buys. Vauxhall Sunday market. Have you been there before?
I went to Leeds Sunday market. I've never been to Vauxhall Sunday market.
Probably the same. I know what Leeds is like. I've heard about Leeds.
I used to buy bootleg PlayStation 1 games there.
I respect that.
Long, long time ago. Good times. But they're now pushing in towards the A site here. Full buy, Sheep with the op. In return, the CTs Oh, they're actually going to make a frag here. Imagine! Oh! Oh, excellently done. Stops them from planting the bomb. And it's a 3v4 now, but Chris makes it a 3v3 with a frag towards mid. He's coming in from connector. Imagine he's still alive in a really, really annoying position because the bomb's right is down right now. And Avant have to try and pick it up. They have to make the frags. Yam is ready and waiting here in connector to take down Chris. And all of a sudden, from a pretty good start for Avant, it seems like it might be something else, but Imagine goes down to Haz and now to 2v2. 45 seconds left on the clock. There is plenty of time, but James with the FAMAS. Oh, and he completely mows them down.
You beast.
What a beautiful spray down with the FAMAS.
Yeah, the problem with Imagine's spot behind that box is that he has no idea what angle is safe. So if he pops out, it's reasonably likely that he's going to get taken out as well.
Yeah.
Taken out he did get, but Immunity saved the round with that fourth buy. Very nice play by them.
Excellently done. And actually forcing Avant on a force buy. Well, not a... Well, actually, Nade... Yeah, it is a force buy, really. Because...
Well, let's have a look at my money. They've only got one with armor. No, it's not a force buy.
It's not a force buy.
They're keeping their money... Well,
Sheep's gone
all in.
He's been buying the AWP. Oh, he's gone for the armor. Wait. No. He just bought all the nades.
Yeah. Enough money.
Okay. But this is pretty dangerous. With the nades and the tech nines, I mean, they already won a round with just tech nines only, no nades. But look at this DVR. He'll pick up yet another frag.
This is a complete mess. PT should not have been pushing like that on his own versus an eco. That's the power of the Tech 9. You close the distance and they get one shot to the head. That's the worst thing you could possibly do.
But look at
and
this.
They get a rifle out of it as well.
Great play there by Ricky, and Imagine there to support as well. By James. And Imagine he'll pick up two. And this is really, really good because if it wasn't for James there staying alive and getting those two frags, Avant would have probably been able to get the bomb plant. But it's still a 2v1. And DVR does have the Tech 9. Get straight for him. Oh, Tech 9 not landing any shots. He survives. 8-6. Immunity picking up a good round there, and much needed round because Avant have already got 6 rounds. And if they won that, I mean, looking at the economy as it is now, if they lost that round, they would have been in a lot of trouble because the loser bonus would have been absolutely gone.
It was far too expensive for them. I think James should rename his knife to T-Virus.
T-Virus.
Yeah, I think it needs to happen. Although it's not as bad as the Marvel. Actually, the Marble Phase should be T-Virus. Because that's like Resident Evil tier.
Fair enough. We'll look at this little space here. And the smoke. PTG's trying to do a cheeky one. He's expecting the ground at the moment.
Yeah, these smokes from Raja are quite interesting because you can often find little gaps. He didn't find a gap, but he found the angle. And that will be an early advantage in the last round of the first half to Immunity.
Ouch.
Getting PTG smoked out again. Up. But look at the position of the CTs. Oh, he finds him, but
he had no idea
it was frag anyway.
Where he was being shot from. Yam's still alive here. He'll get shot down finally by Haz, but they've only got two players now, forcing themselves into a very heavily defended A site. I think in this kind of position, they're probably the back away or just spend some time to make the CTs kind of rotate. Either way, it's 9-6. Immunity picking up 9 rounds in. I mean, James, what do you think? Having 6 rounds on the T side.
That was quite an entertaining half, actually.
It was.
It was back and forth. Yeah. Immunity come out with a 3-round lead. And Ricky is up there with... Sniper's down there with only 3... Hey, wait a minute. Sniper's in my dream team. He's got 3 kills.
Rest in peace, James' dream team.
Someone send him a message. Tell him to pull his socks up.
I mean, Titus already said that your dream team's actually doing quite bad. Is that true?
I'm getting wrecked at the moment. But in fairness, two of my players are
excuses.
Na'Vi.
Okay.
Two of my players are play for Na'Vi, and they have missed a few matches because they were in America. So we're going to have a big Na'Vi week next week. So who knows? I could end up at the top of the leaderboard.
Can't you switch the players? Shouldn't you be switching them around?
Yeah, but I'm not really in a position to at the moment because I'm getting wrecked so bad that I've probably got no money to even sell a player.
We'll start off the second half here with a pistol round. 3-4 armor buy here from Immunity as they are getting ready to push.
If Sniper doesn't get 10 kills in this half, I'm kicking him from my team immediately.
Oh, look at this, Chris. He snipes down
That's
Sniper.
That's not a good start.
Yeah, it's not a good start, mate. I think you should just keep
pressure's
quiet.
Pressure's on you, Sniper. You better fix up, buddy.
You're making it worse for him. You're making it worse for him. It's not helping.
I remember actually, I have a few seconds here. One of my friends got sponsored for a Street Fighter tournament. They sent him to Paris. And while he's in a tournament, they said to him, like, you better come top 4 or you're kicked from the team.
That's not nice.
Like who needs that pressure when they're about to play a tournament? That's completely unnecessary. But those guys were morons.
Look at this great... Oh! That was such a good shot from Chris. Ricky, he'll get the entry frag on PTG and the bomb planted. Chris backs away from shot, stays alive, which is the right thing to do. And Yam... In the other respective, does the right thing and pushes him and gets the frag. Now it's a 3v2 here as DVR gets an entry frag on Ricky. Another frag for DVR. And boom, while in the air, he goes down to Yam. Yam's still alive, picking up the USP. Oh, what a wonderful kill. He could win this 3v1 clutch if he gets the final frag. And there is a defuse kit on Haz, though. He's not got a lot of health. He's going to go for the defuse. Oh, he tries to peek again, and Yam will actually win that 3v1 clutch in fantastic fashion. 4 kills for Yam, 1 round for Immunity. Yeah, specifically, Yamunity.
That's a Yamunity.
Tried to do it.
Wow.
I tried it.
I don't even know where we go from here, Avela. Yamunity.
I'll just make my way towards the door.
All right, so Ricky's going to just go with a Tech 9. 19, 15, the bank going to be going for that AWP later, no doubts. All right, so got a short push here from the CTs. They're going to boost behind the block, in fact. And let's see what they're doing it with. Yeah, we've got DVR in mid.
Not much
that reminds me, actually, there's a fighting game play called Lord DVD.
DVD.
And when he does well, we call him Lord Blu-ray. When he does bad, we call him Lord VHS. But actually, DVD is because his name is David, but like nobody cares. It's DVD. Anyway, big presence here from the T's in the mid area.
Rest in peace.
Oh, man. Yam just got his face chewed off.
That was actually really good by Rick. I don't know how PTG wasn't aware of him being in the ladder room, but really nice movement. And
oh my god. The
Tech 9 is just, it's not fair. It's not fair.
Yeah, that was surely a headshot, but from that distance, it will not be a one tap. And oh, look at this. There's a massive flank coming in from the CTs here. From Sheep, look at the rotation from the remaining CTs. They know what's going on, and he gets a frag as well. Now they're going to be paranoid, but they don't have enough time to really mess around here. The bomb is down. There's 30 seconds left. It's 2 versus 4. This buy round is not going well for them whatsoever.
There's not much they can do at the moment.
They need to make a decision. They need to make it fast. They need to clear a site and plant a bomb quickly.
I think right now they just have to say, oh, they're going for the B site. I mean, 15 seconds left on the clock. CTs just have to back away and stop them from planting. Well, Imagine's going to get the frag, and somehow they're going to get the bomb plant as well. Another frag for Imagine.
Oh, it has. 2 P250s, and Avant Garde say, no, you do not. This match is not over.
Great job by Avant to pick up that round to make it 10-7 and to keep themselves in the game as well and force Immunity onto an eco, which should give them yet another round. Sheep with the AWP already. No armor, no nades, no nothing.
He's naked.
I wouldn't say... naked?
He's naked, man. He's not wearing anything.
Can we see a third person view of that?
He's got no Kevlar helmet. Filthy pervert. I knew he shouldn't have asked you in.
I don't believe your words. I have to see it. Chris again.
Hey, if you want pics, you can ask him privately.
I'll send
That's not what the stream is for, Avela. Look at that.
It's the wall bang.
It's the wall bang.
It finally got a kill. A Chris WoW. He's been holding shot relatively well so far. You're putting the camera at all the deaths. And it looks fantastic.
They're getting spanked on this anti-eco.
Spanked?
Spanked.
And you call me a dirty pervert.
Maybe we both are.
10-8.
Let's just leave that there.
I'm just going to change the subject.
Oh, Ricky's got... See, this is what I'm talking about. Ricky's got a good spawn to just charge up A ramp and try and get a frag. If a player from A tries to run from A towards connector, that's exactly the thing I'm talking about. Unfortunately, he missed it on that occasion. But quite often, you see CTs run across here into the connector area, and that can mean death for them.
Look at this. This mid-push here from the CTs is going to be punished by Yam as he picks up 2 frags. Has finally takes him down. And because... somehow, James died somewhere on the map. I don't remember where. They're actually a 3v3. Haz with another frag. That sniper's going to push in from connector because nobody's checking mid. And it's absolute bananas so far. The bomb's still down at mid. They're going to pick it up and move towards the site. But if he picks a frag here, they should go towards the B site because they know that he just came in from market. Now they're still going to go towards the A site.
Heinous went Super Saiyan for a few seconds there. He just savaged someone through smoke and then just popped out and got a pre-fire towards Palace as well.
Yeah, they are going towards the B site. Smart decision. DVR sees one. Oh! Sniper. No mercy.
The unfavorable angle and just shot him straight in the face.
You must be happy he's got 3 frags. That's half of the amount of frags that he's had this game.
Hey, he's doubled his frags.
Yeah.
This is brilliant.
Good start.
I could barely ask for more, Avela, at this point.
It's because you didn't mention his name anymore. 11-8. Immunity picking up another terrorist round. And because it's been so back and forth, look at their money. They're not able to afford a full buy here. They've gone for armor on two players, CZ and Desert Eagle.
It's GoTV, these grenades is ridiculous.
That makes it interesting.
Spending space and time. Okay, so all the T's are heading over towards the B bomb site. Save for one, just watching the flank. It's going to be... Let's have a look at who that is. That is Sniper, just this keeping an eye on things. But also, it means I don't have to worry about short for while he's doing that.
But there's a slow train outside of the B site. Like they're slowly moving out of the site they're going to, which is not the best choice for them now, but they don't really have access to the information. Now the terrorists should get an easy plant on the B site. Chris sights them, but Yam will put an end to his life.
Yeah, the thing about this is that look at the aggressive positions that the T's can now take. It's going to make it a lot harder for any damage to get done here by the CTs.
Yeah, it's... I mean, if they kept their positions inside the site, they might have been able to do something or other, but they just moved out at the wrong moment, thinking that perhaps they were going towards the A site. But Avant will lose that round. I think they're going to try and save the armor on Sheep.
Oh, you got a flank here.
PTG might get an exit frag and pick up.
Oh, he's got two.
Caster's curse, James.
I've never seen somebody just died like on a flower pot before.
Yeah, on the flower. He's on a flower pot. You gonna take a screenshot? He's taking all the angles.
Oh, look at
photographer
that.
Photographer James.
It's almost like he knows that we're doing it as well.
He looks like he's just chilling.
What a dominating pose.
Yeah.
Standing over the carcass
of his enemies.
All right, so double AWPs coming out for immunity.
Is that the right thing to do usually on the T side?
I don't know, man. These Oceanic teams are nuts. I'm telling you, three AWPs on CT side of Dust 2. They just like the AWPs, man.
Yep. Absolute madness.
Okay, so here's a T-Virus knife on BTG.
Right now, all the different colors. Default setup here by immunity, keeping the map control. They've given away mid. We've got one person pretty deep at B halls.
I'm wondering if PTG's silencer is going to expose his position there.
Look at this. I mean, I don't know how Imagine got into that position without being sighted, but he does see one of the CTs coming through and lands quite a lot of damage on Haz. Follows it up with a nade, but it's not enough to get the frag. Oh, Yam! Great peek. And that's a great bit of teamwork as well. He probably gave him the information that he backed away to jungle, and Yam just timed that peek perfectly. And that's an entry frag, and it seems like the bomb is now moving towards the B site here.
Oh, but look at the information play from the CTs here. PT gets a frag onto Apps, but also DVR has... He just poked his head into lower A and saw that nobody was there. Looks like he's going for another oak as well. But look how far away this rotation is going to be from the CTs as... let's see where the bomb is going. Oh, it's an underpass at the moment because there was Imagine poking around B Apps. So looks like it's going to be a split towards A after all.
Oh, what a shot.
What a shot there by Yam. There's still, though, a player... It could all come down to DVR's position. If he comes out at the right time, he could get two frags!
Yeah, it's the first one. And also, Sheep's in a great position to cut him off from Connector. But Sniper's able to push through and get a frag, get a bomb plant, sorry. It's still 3v2. PTG is going to check CT while one of his teammates is pushing from T-Ramp. And this is a great position here by the terrorist who's hiding at mid, because he knows there's a player there and he will be able to take him out. And it's very important that Sheep should have been able to push in from that position. Either way, they take down DVR, and now it's just PTG on his own against two, running around with a pistol. Oh, the no-scope! And he knows where the final player is.
He doesn't have a kit, though. He can't win the round. It's too late.
Yeah, it's too late. He won't be able to get it.
And he somehow doing? He's like, oh, why maybe, is he going for it?
Maybe if I point my AWP at it, it gets scared.
Maybe if I shoot the bomb.
It won't explode? I don't know.
That was an awkward position for him.
And this is not good news for Avant, who are now 5 rounds behind and on an eco as well. Not good at all. 13-8 now. Avant, in this kind of position, they really should just go for a stack, A site stack, maybe, or any stack, really. Oh, aimbot version Yam.
Nice timing pick there by Yam. Again, those are the things I love about Mirage. You could just be so crazy aggressive on the early stages of a round like that. It's a lot of fun. Okay, so this is a fairly clean round so far. Only Yam going down after Ramboing two people. So they won't be too worried about this. Avant-Garde's money going into the next round. Maybe their final full buy if things don't go well for them. But hopefully it does. I would like to see this go a few more rounds.
It should.
Murder's Excellence. Isn't that like a lyric from a Jay-Z album?
What's that?
Murder's Excellence. The name of somebody's AK.
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure it is. Oh, apparently I'm a thug, according to you.
Me?
Yeah.
No.
Or is it you and Thorin?
No, Thorin said you're a thug, and I was like, James isn't a thug.
Thorin said I'm a thug.
Yeah.
What the hell?
I said, James is like, not very thuggy. He's just a standard...
He thinks I'm a thug.
Londoner. Yeah.
I don't even know.
I mean, do you think that's a bit racist?
No. I don't. If you ask me if I think Thorin's a racist, no, I don't think Thorin's a racist.
No, I don't, but I'm saying you've been thinking you're... But anyway, they're pushing through connector, imagine, and they lose a player.
What the hell is going on?
I have no idea. That was a hard question for you. I could see that. You're thinking about
it. Oh, I didn't know where to go with it.
Chris and Haz, frag each. This is a good start here for Avant this round. And it was interesting. I don't know why they were pushing, running through connector like that, but through the smoke. But Haz, he was there and ready and waiting. Now the Terrace are deciding to regroup. And as I say that, they're not actually deciding to regroup. They've got one person going towards the B site. And maybe they want to get a cheeky plant in the A site and have Sniper fake the B push.
Oh, let's see.
It might be the case.
The CTs don't need to go for any crazy rotations here because they're all alive, so they should be smarter than that.
Yeah, they've got relatively good positions. They've got two guys on the A site. I think PTG should just stay on connector because there is somebody looking at B apps from short. So great flash by PTG coming all the way from short. And that allows Haz to pick up an easy frag on James. Now Sniper, he gets an entry frag on PTG from connector. He'll be shot down by Christo, and Haz catches Yamp. Wow, that was a nice shot through the wall there.
Yeah, they get the AWP as well, and an AK, which is good.
Double up. This is double up is pretty good for the CTs on Mirage. You've got a guy who plays window, or he plays like from jungle, checks palace, or even gets a pick at T ramp, and then you just have a guy at B with an AWP.
What's also nice, depending on how much the T's try to push mid, is playing one short and playing one CPL can be good as well. It's one thing that Flipside do with World Edit, playing CPL and Simple playing short. I know Happy likes to play short with an AWP as well.
Yeah.
Really strong positions, but we're going to see Sheep on the A site with it. This is a position that I think Delpan likes to play.
I mean, Immunity have a lot of time to just try different strats and just go for it, and they're going to go for the B push here. Chris is in a great position to support his teammates, and he gets two frags. There's a rotation from the CTs. They pop down. They're spilling into the site, but Chris makes it a third. Yam burns PTG alive, and the terrorists are pushing into the site here, and they will be able to get a bomb plant. But they're still playing for the peaks, which is a good choice for them here. Good flash there. Imagine knows that somebody's at... Oh, park bench. That was so fast by Imagine. Great shot. Now it's a 2v2. Two ops against two AKs. Not the best position for Avant to be in. And the bomb is actually going towards the A site here. And I think the CTs aren't aware of it yet. They've got Ricky, who's...
Someone's twigged.
Taking up their attention. Oh, he won't be able to make the frag. DVR takes him out. And that was an important frag indeed. Now it's a 2v1. They should be switching to rifles, or one of them at least, to make it an easier job to retake this. But it's a very important round for Avant, because if they don't win this, it should be GG. Oh, he gets the frag in. That's really, really nicely done. But Imagine, he pushed for one angle. He got the information, and he got a free frag with it as well. It's DVR against Imagine in a 1v1, and the hopes of Avant-Garde are on it. He picks up the 5-7. He doesn't land the headshot. He throws the flashes. He has to go for it sooner or later. There's not a lot of time left on the clock, but he won't make it. Imagine gets the frag instead. Excellent play by him to get another 4K and make it 15-9.
It took him really long just to even try and warbang, because, I mean, there are two boxes for him to choose from, but pick one of them. I mean, he did in the end, but he just wasn't enough time there. Although I don't think he was terribly sure at the beginning as to where the T was, but it is match point now, and quite a few here for Immunity. And look at the buy from Avant-Garde. They've gone for the fourth buy, the jumble sale buy. Only two rifles on the board here, so things are not looking good for them at all. And look at the possession of mid. He's in CPL already. There's a minute 30 on the clock, and Yam is in CPL. This is madness.
House invasion by Yam. Tried to go for the scream tap. Didn't land the headshot, though. They've already lost two players. Seems like it's the end of the road for Avant in this match, and Immunity might be going undefeated. Sheep picks up two frags, though. It makes it a more manageable experience for Chris and PTG. Well, they've had pretty good games, both of them. They've just not been able to pick up the rounds on the CT side and get that momentum. PTG pushing in from T-Ramp here. And it's two Desert Eagles against an AWP and two AKs. Oh. Brutal, brutal death. And it's Chris on his own. Seems like it is the final nail on the coffin here, as Immunity will win the game 16-9. Make it 2-0. They win two,
yeah,
two
they
games.
They go 2-0 so far in the Oceanic League. So congratulations to Immunity. Very